When policymakers sit down to think about how they're going to address a pressing policy problem, there's this overwhelming tendency to frame the way they think about that policy problem in terms of either a government solution or a market-based solution. Want to make sure everyone has access to healthcare? Get the government to set up a healthcare system. Want to reduce the cost of telecommunication services? Force incumbents to lease their networks to new entrants. You want to make sure Indigenous communities have access to fire, water, police, and other services? Subsidize the provision of those services. It's a rare public servant who thinks outside this kind of policy box to consider another option, one that looks to vest ownership and control with the people who need to use or consume the good or service. It's a rare public servant who considers the possibility of turning to democratically controlled cooperative organizations. Our goal with this course is nothing more or nothing less than making sure you, the next generation of policymakers, understand that you might have another option. Importantly, a cooperative is not always the best option, but it just might be. To tell the difference, a good policymaker needs to understand the origins of cooperation on an individual and evolutionary level, recognize that organizations, not markets, and not even governments, are the main way we provide for the goods and services that sustain our lives and make the world go round. See that cooperatives already operate in almost every imaginable sector of the economy, but also recognize where they can go wrong and where they work really well. And appreciate how cooperatives can and do govern themselves. Policymakers also need to be wary of claims that cooperatives are somehow less efficient, less agile, and less successful than investor-owned competitors. And finally, policymakers need to recognize how intentional policy or its absence has always shaped and can continue to shape the way cooperatives work. Now, as we go about exploring these topics, you'll learn about cooperatives from a variety of perspectives. You'll hear directly from scholars and experts about their experience in researching cooperatives. You'll read articles from disciplines as diverse as behavioral economics, public administration, economics, and history. You'll also engage in case study exercises with your student colleagues and work through real scenarios. Throughout the course, we will discuss some of the most challenging issues facing modern cooperatives. So one of the big themes in this course is stress that cooperatives can and should be in your policymaking toolkit. And again, that's not to say that they're a solution to all of society's problems. But when we look around the world today and we see all the things that are going wrong and we keep thinking in the same old tired ways of government or market-based solutions, you should be open to the idea that there is another way of thinking. Theory, history, and just everyday experience tells us there is another option and we need to take it seriously. I hope you will join my course on cooperatives and the new economy.